Hello and welcome to another CF Power Scripts tutorial with me, Christian Rauchenwald. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can add the Google Analytics Ecom Tracking Power Script to your funnels to track your sales and conversion in Google Analytics as well. Now, as always, in order to get started, you need to log into your CF Power Scripts account, and once there, head from the dashboard to the Power Scripts section. Now, theoretically, you could add this script globally to your funnel as it has some other requirements, and if they are not met, it will not do anything. But for the purpose of this demo, I'm going to pick our development funnel here, and I'm simply going to click Add New, look for the Google Analytics Ecommerce Tracking Script, click on it, and click on Add Script. Now, as mentioned before, there are a few requirements. First of all, you need to make sure that you've also added the Google Analytics Power Script, which provides your funnel with the basic Google Analytics tracking code, which tracks your page views. And additionally, in order to track your up and down sells properly, you also need to add the conversion tracking add-on. Now, when you're adding those scripts, they come with their own step-by-step tutorials, so I'm not going to go too deep into that. Now, in order to test everything, you can go to Google Analytics, and there, make sure that you pick the right pixel or the right property and the right view. So for me, it's our test ID that we are using here. And go to real time and overview. Now, in case you didn't know, Google Analytics does not track things in real time the way Facebook does. With Facebook, we can see our transactions in real time. With Google Analytics, we'll only see that the purchase event has fired, and you will see the actual transaction with a 24-hour delay in your account, but I'm going to show you where as well. Now, once we have that prepared, we can go back to CF Power Scripts, and we can go to one of our order form funnel steps and click on the icon next to the funnel page. You will only see one page here if you're not running a split test, and therefore you'll open that page and you just open the live funnel step. Now, once there, we simply copy the test credit card number, scroll down all the way, enter it here, and I'm going to pick a payment plan product and the order bump and click on complete enrollment to submit that order form. Now, I'm also going to take the upsell here, and with that, we are going to end up on our order confirmation page where we can see our latest purchase down here showing the payment plan plus the order bump plus the one-time purchase. Now, in Google Analytics, we can see that we have one visitor, and when we go to events, we can see that the purchase event in the e-commerce category has been fired. And when we click on it, unfortunately, it doesn't show us much more. And the actual product details will be displayed delayed when you go to conversions, e-commerce, and there, for example, to the overview. And within 24 hours, your purchase or your test transaction will show up here, listing the product names and the quantity sold, as well as the revenue made from those products, your average order value, how many unique purchases there happened, and how many transactions happened. Now, as said, in many cases, the data will not be reflected in real time. However, I've been testing previously a little bit already before recording this video, so you can already see that I have a test or two test transactions here that fired properly. And when I adjust the date range to reflect today instead of showing the last 7 days, we can also see that a few transactions from today have also been recorded. Now, they will be listed like this. You will see the product name, the quantity sold, the percentage of the quantity, how it's split up. And you can go through the other categories and you can see the transaction ID, which is the ClickFunnels purchase ID. Now, when you click on one of those transactions, you can see the details, so which products were part of that transaction. And you can see that it contains the payment plan, the one-time product, which was our upsell, and the order bump that I bought additionally on the order form funnel step. That's it. That's how easy you can add Google e-commerce tracking to your funnels in ClickFunnels, thanks to CF Power Scripts. Now, as mentioned, the Google Analytics e-commerce tracking Power Script requires you to also have the regular Google Analytics Power Script in place that provides the tracking ID and the conversion tracking add-on Power Script, which provides additional information that is required for the tracking itself. Now, you may be wondering why we have that additional conversion tracking add-on Power Script. It may seem like an additional step for you at first, but when you start tracking on more platforms, so for example, you're tracking your data on Facebook and you're tracking your data on Google, you will see that it actually saves you time because that conversion tracking add-on is the core of all our tracking scripts. So you don't have to add that additional information for every platform where you want to track your purchases, but you only have to add it once, fill in the additional information, especially for your up and down sells, and all the other tracking scripts, so the Google Analytics tracking script, the Facebook tracking script, and so on. They can then use that data so you don't have to add it over and over again. As always, if you have any questions whatsoever, make sure to take a look at our FAQ section. And if you cannot find the answer there, go ahead and create a post within our Facebook community. Or if you're a member of our VIP plan, text us within the Slack application that is available to you, or simply use our contact form and create a ticket with us. We're more than happy to help you with all your issues and questions. Thanks for watching, and even more so, thanks for using CF PowerScript. See you in one of our other tutorials. Till then, bye-bye.